In your next Bible reading, I'd like for you to read in the book of Genesis, chapters 5 through 9. Your next Bible reading, read in the book of Genesis, chapters 5 through 9. It's from these passages we'd like to take our topic for the night, and we'll call it the mess in Noah's ark. The mess in Noah's ark. We're going to ask you to help us combine hearts and minds in our thoughts.
Yes, sir.
Hearing from heaven.
Yes, sir.
The singing of this old one.
Yes.
I heard the voice of Jesus saying,
oh.
mess in Noah's ark.
Amen.
It is very easy today to get a conversation on the church. If you want to start folk to talking, whether you're on the bus, in the beauty parlor, the barber shop, or whether it's on your job during the break, you start talking about the church. And everybody you meet, whether they go to church or not, they have an opinion about the church. One of the more common opinions about the church is that the church is a mess. You can hear folk who are in the church and folk who are not in the church commenting on God's church. Some say, well, I don't go to church because the folk too messy. That was about Jesus. Preach the Holy Word. They claim that their reason for not getting up Sunday morning and preparing their bodies and souls to go and stretch out to God is that the folk in the church are too messy. I'm ready to agree that the church may be messy, but it's God's mess. It's better to be in some mess than to be out of it. I can imagine with two of every kind of animal, two of every kind of flying and crawling and creeping thing on board in Noah's ark. I imagine it was a mess in Noah's ark. But if you could call some of those folk back that was not on the ark, they could tell you it was a bigger mess outside of the ark.
The church was not designed to be heaven on earth.
Yes,
the church was not designed to be the perfect place on earth.
Y'all gonna play with me?
Yes.
It's strange that we would come to church expecting the church to be perfect.
All right.
When our homes are not perfect. When all of our homes get perfect, and then when we come to church, we'll have a perfect church. But as long as our homes are not perfect, we ought not expect the church to be perfect.
God did not design the church to be heaven on earth.
This is not God's temporary heaven.
Amen.
But even Jesus himself said, the church is a bare wheat field. But let the wheat and the tare grow together.
Y'all gonna pray with me?
See, even Jesus said, the church is a bad wheat field, but let the wheat and the tare grow together.
Yeah.
Jesus said that the church was a general hospital.
Amen.
And folk who are sick with sin could come to the hospital for treatment. If they got the Lyme disease, let them come. If they have hormone disease, let them come. If they have backbiting disease, let them come. If they have the alcoholic disease, let them come. If they have the drug addict disease, let them come. Whatever the sickness is, Dr. Jesus can treat the sickness. No matter how bad the sickness is, Dr. Jesus can treat the sickness. Church, God's general hospital.
That need we have here in the church, two things that have always been in the church, is money and trouble. Hope we are afraid to give or don't want to give, don't want to be in God's church. Folk who are afraid of trouble, who are coward soldiers, don't want to be in God's church. Sin is contagious. Sin is catching. Sin is just like an eating cancer. It doesn't get better. It always gets worse. The sin of Adam and Eve went on to their children. And you find the first children at odds with one another. And you find Cain willing to kill his brother. And he killed his brother not because his brother was doing anything to him. But he killed his brother because his brother pleased God. And you know folks will get mad at you right now. When you do things to please God. You get up Sunday morning and come to Sunday school. And you pay your tithe and give an offering. Then you're showing that it's possible to do what God wants you to do. Folk will get mad with you for doing what God will have you to do. Somebody know what I'm talking about. Let me put it like this, if you will. Therefore, perhaps somebody here at this very moment who have said to a friend or to a loved one in the church, well, I'm not going to do that.
just not able to do it. And then they'll try to tell you, if I was you, somebody know what I'm talking about. I wouldn't try to do it either. And then when you go on and do it anyhow, they get mad with you. And they say, well, she just doing it for an outside show. Y'all gonna pay me anyhow? Well, the world didn't get any better. The world continued to grow wicked. The world continued to get dark with the sin and wickedness of man. The Bible tells us that there was a man whose name was Enoch.
That's right.
No.
And it said of this man that he walked with God. And he was not, for God took him. Oh, it's mighty good, my friend, to walk and talk with God. You know, some of us are so busy talking to God until we don't have time to listen and let God talk to us. Some of us are so busy telling God about our enemies.
Oh, yes.
Some of us are so busy telling God to make our enemies leave us alone. Until we can't hear God saying, leave your enemies alone.
Yes,
but Enoch walked with God. I can imagine it was something like what my grandmother used to tell me about. Before the days that they had television and telephones, she said when they would get through working in the fields all day long, they would gather in the homes of one another.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
And they would have a private meeting in the home.
Yes, sir.
And she said when the private meeting was over, the owner of the house would say to one of those attending the meeting, well, let me walk you. Peace the way home. She said, while they were walking, peace the way, they would be talking about God. Sometimes the conversation got so good until the one who was walking along peace the way. And they would get the boys up and down the road talking about my God. I can imagine it was something like that with God and me. Every evening in the cool of the day, God would come down and walk with him. So far one way, and they'll turn around and walk back the other way. One day the conversation got so good, I could hear God saying to him, Enoch, you're nothing but a lily in the mud. Enoch, you walk so far with me. And it's a long ways back to your house. I'm going to let down the drawbridge of eternity. And instead of walking you peace the way back,
Show you the way.
Crocodile getting into it with one another.